next guest is a furry social media star with 200,000 followers on Instagram, but he started out on death row for dogs at just 5 weeks old. Pikelet was rescued from a council shelter and 4 years on has become an ambassador for Rescue Dogs Australia. Please welcome him to Studio 10 along with his mum, Callie. You've got to talk us through his outfit. I love it.
Yeah, so he's wearing a checkered shirt that's been sent over from the States. Actually, so is his collar and leash. They both come from two different companies who have sent him these lovely...
I love that he's wearing smart casual for the morning. Yes. Tell us about the moment that you decided to adopt Pikelet when you saw him in the shelter. What made him different to all the other dogs?
Yeah, so, excuse my voice, I'm a little bit croaky. We were asked to foster him by the rescue group who saw Pikelet on death row at about 8 weeks old. Pikey, sit down, buddy. And he came to us in a sort of not a great condition. He had a condition called rickets. Oh. So his little legs were quite bowed and his back was also quite curved. And because of that, we made the commitment as foster carers to care for him for a little bit longer than what we normally would. And of course, caring for him for that little bit longer pretty much sealed the deal. I fell in love with him.
Some people are frightened to get a rescue dog, aren't they? Because they fear they won't turn out all right or they might.
He's done very well there. He's having a facial.
Yeah, look, and that's the thing. That's the part about what we do on social media. It's to sort of break down that misconception that rescue dogs are all broken or damaged or... you know, they've got troubles and problems. You know, the only thing that was different about Pikelet was that he did have a health condition, which, you know, with a couple of weeks of good nutrition, you know,
they just need a bit of loving, don't they?
That's right.
He's a staffy. You got him as a puppy. Yep. Why was he on death row?
Well, we think that he was on death row because he didn't look perfect as far as puppies go.
So he might have been bred by a breeder for sale, but didn't quite
and wasn't given the care that he needed. So yeah, and then he was found as a stray. So
tell us about those photos, because with the cucumbers over his eyes and the little towel around him, how on earth do you get him to pose like this? Obviously he's a natural star.
Yeah, look, I mean, he's been posing since he was a baby puppy, since the day we got him. Look, it's really just a lot of bribery, bit of treats. And I also just don't put him in positions that are actually that difficult. You know, him lying back and having cucumbers on his eyes and a bit of pampering is not that difficult, you know.
So does he like being a star in this book, The Extraordinary Life of Pikelet?
He does. He definitely knows that he's a little bit famous and that he...
Does he?
Oh, yeah.
Wow, what do you mean? Does he go to the front of the queue when it comes to a restaurant?
Yeah, everywhere he goes, he gets recognised and... you know, gets all the attention.
In the book, you say he swallowed your engagement ring. How did you find out?
Well, it went missing, and I suspected that he swallowed it because the day we got him from the pound, he actually pooped out a bottle cap. So I knew that he had a history of swallowing things he shouldn't. The ring was missing for an entire week. We looked everywhere. I had him x-rayed and everything.
Didn't see it in there?
Didn't see it in there. And everybody thought I was just blaming him when really I'd lost it. But we had a lot of heavy rain that week and...
He looks like he's washed saying, away. I'm innocent.
That's right. Washed away some poo in the backyard and... lo and behold, there was my ring.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh.
And that was actually, my husband had said up until that point, I'd been asking him every day, can we adopt him? And he got to a point where he said, look, if you find the ring, you can keep the dog. So, of course, we found the ring and within 30 seconds of finding that ring, I was on the phone to the rescue saying, we're keeping him. He's ours, you know.
Is this right, Pikelet?
Yeah.
Yes, is this right? Does he look guilty? I think he looks a bit guilty. Pikelet, you know you've done wrong. Yeah, he reckons so. And what about all the other animals you and your husband have adopted? I mean, not just dogs, there have been rats and all sorts of things.
Yeah, so we've fostered about 50 animals in the last couple of years.
Have you got a great paddock where you put them all?
We don't. We live in a really tiny city house, so I think that's the novelty of what we do. But mostly they're puppies. Mm. But we have fostered some baby ducklings and a couple of piglets and even a baby goat quite recently.
I love that. And I love that you dress your dogs up. Jessica dresses her cats up and gets hours of pleasure out of it.
Yeah.
What are you dressing Parker up for Halloween as?
Oh, gosh, I haven't even thought about it, honestly. I haven't thought about it this year. Previous years he's been Dracula and...
Dracula, you poor thing.
Yeah. He's telling me.
And none of that's Photoshop.
That's brilliant. And you're taking trick-or-treating for a dog treat or two?
Well, usually we stay home dressed up and the kids come to us, so, yeah.
He is just the best dog.
Yeah, he's a good boy, he's a good boy.
Parker's going on a book tour?
That's correct.
What's he going to sign up with his paw?
He is. I think that one's been signed.
I think
signed
it is signed.
Little paw.
Oh, look, it is signed. Look.
It's a Pikelet original.
It is, yeah. So we leave this Friday, we head off to Perth. So he's flying right around the country, meeting all his fans.
Look, as one author to another, I can tell you the book tour is the hardest part. It's all very well to write the book Pikelet, but marketing the book is a hell of a business.
Oh, that's correct. Now, if you would like to keep across Pikelet's adventures, you can follow him on Instagram at @lifeofpikelet. The posts will definitely make your day and your week. Pikelet and Mum Callie, thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me.